So we are continuing the anemia. Now we proceed to normocytic anemia. Microcytic we have already done. Now we go to normocytic anemia. So we have already named this before. One is what? Paroxysmal nocturnal hemoglobinuria. Paroxysmal nocturnal hemoglobinuria. From the word itself we can come to the answer. This is pancytopenia. There will be decrease in every cells. It is negative Coombe test. This anemia will show negative Coombe test. And you will have hemoglobinuria. Remember, like in mnemonics. Now, what is the main mechanism here? There will be decrease in two genes, CD55 and decrease in CD59. Actually, these are the genes, they will stop C3 convertase have to be stopped because they will activate membrane activating complex. And that leads to lysis of cells. Actually, if these genes are absent, they can't block this. If no blocking, they will activate and they will make anemia. They will make lysis of cells. So that's all you have to remember about PNS. And the gene itself is called PIGA gene. The gene affected in paroxysmal nocturnal hemoglobinuria is PIGA gene is mainly affected. Now next anemia in normocytic is G6PD deficiency anemia. Remember why we need G6PD to make glutathione. We have discussed this in biochemistry deeply before. We know glutathione is a good antioxidant. Actually, to make glutathione, we need NADPH. To make NADPH, we need glutathione. Glutathione. For making glutathione, I need which enzyme? G6PD. So there are some babies who are born without G6PD, so no NADPH. Actually, RBC is protected by what? Glutathione. Protection is by glutathione, reduced glutathione. But in babies who are born without G6PD, no glutathione, so no NADPH, so no reduced glutathione. So they will have lysis of RBC and two types of body you see here. Haynes bodies and white cell. Haynes bodies and white cell. Here I am talking about G6PD deficiency anemia. Remember, this G6PD deficiency anemia is also called favism. Because if this child will eat a bean called fava beans, they will have more problems. They will have more hemolysis. So never give them fava bean. It's a type of bean that can increase the severity of this anemia. And remember, there are some other drugs you cannot give these babies, to include anti-malarial drug. Never give these babies anti-malarial drug like primacune, chloracune, anti-malarial drugs. Like example like primacune. There's a drug for celiac disease that is called Dapsone or sulfur drug, Dapsone, other sulfur drugs. Never give them aspirin. So these are contraindicated in which babies? The babies who are having normocytic anemia, G6PD, this will cause more hemolysis. So that's all you have to remember about G6PD anemia. Next normocytic anemia is very important. That was our hereditary spherocytosis. It's also normocytic. Remember, it is autosomal dominant. Normally for an RBC, its shape and size is maintained by three proteins. They are ankyrin, spectrin, and band cell. If there is any mutation in any of these proteins, they can have change in shape of RBC and size. That condition itself is called hereditary spherocytosis. Remember, it is what? Autosomal dominant. Now remember, it is also negative Coombe's test. Here you will see a specific body called Hogel-Jolly bodies. Because what is affected here? Spleen is affected here. As a result, we can have splenomegaly. Remember, that is very, very important. Autosomal dominant. hereditary spherocytosis. There are a lot of questions they used to ask here. So that's all about all the normocytic anemia we have remembered for all the exams. Thank you.